Hey guys, what's up? This is Mumbai Ka Nikhil, and today I would like to talk about the mileage of Duke and RC 200, and of course the RC and Duke 390, and also the heating problem of Duke 390 and also RC 390. They both have the same engine, so it's apparently the same thing. Okay, the mileage of Duke 200. Most of you have asked me that what is the mileage of Duke 390, what is the mileage of Duke 200, comparatively which bike is good, comparatively which bike I should go for, Duke or RC. See guys, the choice is yours. Okay, first fix your mind which bike you want to go for, what will be your purpose of your riding, whether it will be city riding most of the time, will you use your bike for just to go to the office or college, or will you use your bike to do more of a touring and less of an office? So if it's more of a city traffic, more of college rides, more of office or whatever, then I think 200 RC 200 or Duke 200 is your, it's supposed to be your choice. And if it's touring, then I think it's Duke 200 or Duke 390. 390 is better for touring because it has a bigger engine. Okay, the mileage. Duke or RC 200 will give you somewhere around 28 kilometers per liter to 38 kilometers per liter. Depends how are you riding. If you're stuck in this kind of traffic, then your Duke 200 and RC 200 will deliver a mileage of 30 to 33 kilometer per liter. But again, depends how you ride. If you're revving it hard all the time, then you're not gonna get good mileage, of course, right? You're gonna get somewhere around 28 to 31 kilometers per liter, maybe less than 30. But if you're riding it, you know, if you're respecting your bike, if you're riding it, if you're shifting your gears before 5,000 RPM, and if you are under 7,500 RPM, and if you're riding it peacefully, then and if most of the time you're above the third gear, then the Duke 200 RC 200 will give you somewhere around 35 kilometers per liter to 38 or maybe 39 kilometers per liter. I don't own a Duke 200. Two or three of my friends own a Duke 200, and that's what they have experienced with the mileage. Okay, and let's come to Duke 390 mileage and RC 390 mileage. I don't own an RC 390. None of my friends own an RC 390, but if they have the same engine, then they should give the same mileage. That's what I think. And I've checked internet. Most of the people have claimed the same mileage which I'm getting on my Duke 390. Okay, bumper to bumper city traffic, horrible mileage. You're gonna get somewhere around 15 kilometers per liter to 20 kilometers per liter. City and highway mix, you're gonna get around 22 kilometers per liter. On an average, you're gonna get 22 kilometers per liter. Only highways, you're gonna get 25 to 26 kilometers per liter. Long touring highways, where you're gonna be most of the time on 5th or 6th gear, you're gonna get 28 to 30 kilometers per liter. If you are under 7,500 RPM, that is. If you're over 7,500 RPM on a top gear also, you're gonna get somewhere around 26 kilometers per liter. I did a Bangalore-Mumbai ride. On an average, I have received 25 to 26 kilometers per liter from my Duke 390. I hope I have made myself very clear with the mileage. Now I'll talk about the heating problem of Duke 390. But before talking that, I would also like to talk about the heating problem of 200. Duke 200 also heats up, but not as compared to Duke 390. Duke 200 is 10 kilos lighter than Duke 390. Duke 390 has a high compression ratio and bigger piston compared to Duke 200. Duke 390 feels little heavy from the how can I say, when you, it feels very heavy in the front, like when you hold the handlebar, you'll feel handlebar very heavy. Okay, so bumper to bumper city traffic, it will heat up a lot. Because if you're stuck in first and second gear and you're gonna feel the heat a lot over your crouch area and over your legs. RC390, you will not feel the heat that much because it has a fairing and all the air is diverted on the belly of the bike, so you will not face that much the heating problem. But yes, you will face, but not that much compared to Duke 390. But yes, your bike will heat up and it will show a high coolant warning if you're riding continuously at first and second gear and city to city traffic. And don't be surprised if your bike refuses to start after the high coolant temperature warning. I don't think you will be able to start your bike for 10 to 15 minutes because your bike wants to get cooled down. Okay, see guys, Duke 390 and RC390 is not a bike which is meant to be ridden in city traffic. It is a bike which demands speed. It is a bike which demands highway. So don't get a bike. Don't get a 390 if you want to ride in city to city, in bumper to bumper city traffic most of the time, or in traffic all the time. Or it's not an office bike, guys. You know, it's kind of a long distance bike. Duke is like it's more of a tourer. RC is more of a track bike, especially 390. If you'll ask me which bike is good for track, RC200, RC390, even the Power Drift has said it in their videos that RC200 is a little better, and I think that's kind of a fact because I have ridden RC200 and RC390, and I would say RC200 feels much better because it's lighter and I cannot make you understand. You will, when you ride it, you'll feel it. Duke 390, it is meant to be ridden in the highway and for your touring, and RC390 as well. But as the RC has a super sport position, so you will feel the pain if you are going somewhere over 300 kilometers. After 300 kilometers, you're gonna feel the pain on your wrist, on your shoulders. Even in Duke, you're gonna feel the pain on your wrist, shoulders, and butt everywhere. But comparatively, I'm talking about RC will give you more pain because it has a super sport position, and for most of you guys, it will cause a back problem. Now don't get me wrong, that doesn't mean that you cannot take your RC anywhere. I know my friends who own a R15 have taken their bike from Mumbai to Ladakh and back from Ladakh to Mumbai. So if an R15 owner can take their bike from Mumbai to Ladakh, RC200 and 390 owners also can take their bike from Mumbai to Ladakh. It's your dedication. But if you're not a dedicated rider, then think about it. RC is not a bike for you. RC is not a cup of tea for everyone. And do a small research before buying the bike. Don't just buy the bike because it looks good, because obviously RC looks much better than Duke. So just don't buy the bike. Don't waste your parents' money or your hard-earned money just because it looks good. You know, do a little bit of research. See which bike will suit you the most. Okay, if you owe like a Splendor for your office or Discover for your office commute, then yes, you can go for RC390 or RC200 because obviously you're gonna go for your weekend ride. You can use RC for your weekend ride, and even 390 as well. Anyways, I will stop talking now. I hope you've got the point, and best of luck for whichever bike you'll go, and for all the owners, ride hard and ride safe. Do click on the subscribe button, and if you like the video, do click on thumbs up. And also guys, if you think I have misguided someone, you can comment below and you can click on the dislike button as well. Okay, cheers, bye.